And here's my solution. We have four cases. On the left side, if I'm on the left side of the race course, as defined at x is smaller to a radius, then my crosstalk error is defined by the distance to the circle centered at radius comma radius minus the radius itself. So this is going to be zero if I'm exactly on the circle. If I'm more than three times over to the right side, I get a circle again, looks like the one before, but now the center of the circle is a little bit further to the right by three times the radius as opposed to one radius. The rest is identical to the line over here, so I'm subtracting the same radius on the right side. You can't quite see it, but it's there. Interesting are the straightaways. So if my y value is large, I'm in the upper part of the diagram, in fact it's larger than radius, then my crosstalk error is the y coordinate times two times the radius, which is the height of the racetrack. If I'm down at the bottom, it's just the y-axis, but really important is the minus sign, because I'm moving in the opposite direction. So for your code to run this correctly, you would have got everything in this routine right. So that finishes my homework assignment. Congratulations, you were able to make a car drive on a racetrack. That is actually quite a significant component of making cars drive. The PID control methodology that you learned today and the smoothing methodology are really, really essential, not just in controlling self-driving cars, but in a great number of other control setups. Thank you for taking the class so far. You learned a lot already. You learned about localization, about planning and control. And we're almost done talking about how to build a self-driving car.